Welcome to Help for Kodi Learning. I am Ashish Gadpaile, your Java trainer. Today we are going to discuss about thread synchronization in Java. So guys, what is mean by synchronization? The process of allowing multiple threads to modify an object in a sequence is called as synchronization. Means if multiple threads are allowing to execute, and if you want to modify that object, if you want to execute that object in a some sequence, so we should go with synchronization. So what is happening inside a multi-threading? When we were executing multiple thread, so we can't expect here exact output, which thread will get highest priority, which thread will be executed first. So they are executing simultaneously. But sometime we may have a requirement to execute a thread in a sequence. It means once my first thread is executed, then second thread should be start. So in such a case, we have to use the synchronization in Java. So guys, what is the advantage of synchronization? To overcome data inconsistency problem, we should go with the synchronization. So means there may be a problem of data inconsistency. So in such a case, we have to use the synchronization, because if multiple threads are allowed to execute, so that time there may be possible to mismatch the data, mismatch the results. So in such case, we have to use the synchronization. So guys, what is the disadvantages of it? It increases the waiting time of a thread. So whenever we are executing the one thread at a time, so of course CPU utilization will be less. So if CPU utilization will be less, so it takes more time. So this is the main disadvantages of the synchronization. So guys, let's discuss a real life example of synchronization. So what is happening inside a railway ticket reservation system? For example, there are only 4 tickets available to book, and person 1 is there and person 2 is there. Person 1 is requested for 3 tickets and person 2 is requested for 2 tickets. So how to solve this problem? So there may be a data inconsistency problem, because we have only 4 tickets and person 1 is requested for 3 tickets, person 2 is requested for 2 tickets, but we don't have 5 tickets. So how to solve this problem? This problem will be solved by using a synchronize method in Java. So whenever we are creating any method by using a synchronize keyword, so it is a synchronize method. So only one thread is allowed to execute at a time. So until completing one thread, other thread is will be the in the waiting state. So here person 1 is requested for 3 tickets, means it will be locked with the only person 1. So until completing person 1 task, person 2 will be in the waiting state. At the same time, if person 3 is requested, so person 3 will be also in a waiting state. So when person 1 will be executed, so that lock will be released and only 1 tickets will be available. So person 2 can book 2 tickets there. But suppose there may be a problem, that is a transaction fail or any problem is there with person 1. So now person 2 is requested for 2 tickets, so person 2 can allow to book 2 tickets then. If suppose there may be a problem with person 2, so then person 3 may be able to book the tickets. So whenever we use the synchronize method, so it will be locked with that person, and other threads and other person will be in the waiting state. So it's the main example of the railway ticket reservation system, because for each request, one thread is created, and when thread is created, so it will be locked with that thread and other threads will be in the waiting state. So this is the perfect example of the synchronization in Java. So guys, let's discuss few of the important points of the synchronization. So internally, synchronization is implemented by using the lock concept. In Java, every object has a unique lock. If a thread wants to execute a synchronize method on the given object, first it has to lock that object. So guys, once thread gets the lock, then it is allowed to execute any synchronize method in that object. Once my thread execution is completed, then automatically a thread will release that lock. So acquiring and releasing lock internally take care by the JVM. So we no need to handle this lock concept. So here the processor is not responsible for this lock concept activity. So while a thread is executing synchronize method on the given object, here the remaining threads are not allowed to execute any synchronize method simultaneously on the same object. Means if a thread is executing synchronize method, other threads will be in the waiting state. But here remaining threads are allowed to execute non-synchronized method simultaneously. Means if other non-synchronized methods are available, so that other threads waiting of the synchronized method, so that threads can continue their execution with the non-synchronized method. So let's discuss an example for the synchronization. So for example, we have a class, that is thread demo we have, and what we are doing, we are going to create a synchronized method, and synchronized method will be available in a class, and we are going to create multiple threads, and we are trying to execute that thread by using a synchronized keyword and without using the synchronized keyword. So like let me create a class there. So for example, I have a class A, and this A class is having a method Like suppose I am having a method public. Suppose I am going to create a static method that is public static void print method I am going to create. So print method I am going to create here, and here I am passing a parameter that is a string. Suppose I have a MSG. So one of the variable we have that is string MSG. Then what we are going to create? We are going to create this synchronize method. So public static, we have to use the synchronize keyword. Synchronized keyword. Okay. So we have to create a synchronized method. So now this method is a synchronized method. Now what we are going to do? We are going to execute. So we are creating a logic. That is what I am doing here. So like I less than I equals to zero, then my I will be executed. Till I less than equals to three time it is executing. Otherwise we can execute three times. Okay. Now I plus plus is there. Okay. Now what I am doing here? I am printing a message. So system dot out dot println. I am going to print, and what I am going to print? I will pass a value to this parameter MSG. In this MSG we have to print. So whatever my thread will be there. So my thread will be executed. So my first thread will be the thread, and with the thread we have to pass this MSG. Okay. Whatever thread name will be we are passing, so that will be printed here. Okay. Now here we have to use this sleep method. See the result in some time interval. So what we have to do? We have to call this sleep method. So sleep method throws this interrupted exception. That's why we have to create the try catch block here. So what we are going to create? We are creating the try catch block. So try thread dot sleep method. Thread dot sleep method is there. And I am passing their time as an argument, like 400 I am passing here. Okay. So time as an argument we have to pass. Then what we are going to do? We are going to create the catch block here. Catch block, and can catch block may throw interrupted exception. So that is interrupted exception it can throw. And this is the catch block. Now what we are going to do? We are going to create a threads. So we are going to create the three threads here. So how do we create the child thread then? Class, suppose my thread one. Suppose we have a thread that is my thread one. We are going to create class my thread one, and my thread extends thread class. My thread extend the thread class. So if my thread is extending the thread class, we have to override that is run method. So public void run method we have to override. So in run method, what logic I am going to add? That is, I am calling this static method, that is class A method I am calling here. So what I am doing? A dot print I am going to call. A dot print I am going to call. That is print method we have. And in print method, what we are doing? We are just passing a message. This is my thread one is there. So what is this? This is my thread one is there. So my one thread we are going to pass. So my thread one will be copied to this string MSG, and then MSG will be print three times. So this child thread we have created. Same what we are going to do, we are going to create that is another two threads, two child threads we have to create. So we are going to create this thread class two, then we are going to create thread class three. Okay, public void run method will be there, and it will be call internally, that is a dot print, mean a class is having a print method. So this three child thread we are going to create. Now what we have to do? We have to create the object of this child thread here, and we have to start it. So whenever we are calling the start method, so it will be called internally to the run method. Okay, so what we are going to do? So create an object first, my thread one t equals to new my thread one, and what we can do? We can call it t dot start method. So t dot start we can. Otherwise, we don't need to create the object. We can directly create the anonymous object. So let's create anonymous object here. So like no need to create the object here. So new my thread one will be created. Okay, and then directly we can mention this start. So anonymous object with dot start. Then similarly, we have to call these two threads again. So we have that is thread 2 and thread t. So we three objects are created. I hope no error is there. So we have created a synchronized method. So what synchronized method is doing? It is for loop will be executed 3 times. Okay, whatever message will be passed, the first my thread 1 will be passed, so it will be print 3 times. Secondly, my thread 2 will be passed, so it will be print 3 times. And third, my thread 3 has passed, so what it will do? It will print 3 times. So whenever it will print 3 times, so it is a synchronized method. So only my thread 1 will be print continuously 3 times. So until my thread 2, it will be in the waiting set because it is a synchronized method. So let's execute it so we people have a clarity. So now my method name is, my class name is Java C thread demo.java. Thread demo.java. So let me compile this code first. So it is showing that system.out.println. Okay. So we have to add here. Okay. Now let me run again. Let me compile and run. Okay. Now what it will do? It is printing 3 times continuously. Okay. So my thread 1 is printed 3 times because it is synchronized method. It will be locked first my thread 1. Okay. Then it will be locked with the my thread 3. So my thread will be 3 will be printed 3 times. Then it will be locked with the my thread 2. So my thread 2 will be printed 3 times. Again, let me execute. Same output is there. Okay. So whenever my thread 1 is executing, so my thread 3 and my thread 2 will be in the waiting state. So now what I am going to do? I am going to remove this synchronize. So if it is a non-synchronized method, so of course multiple threads can allow to execute this method. So here we can't expect now output. So now let me run this code. So Java C, thread demo.java, and then thread demo. So let's, you can see here output is the mismatch output, mix output will be there. We can't expect here exact output, what will be the output. It is depend on the thread scheduler, and that 3 algorithms are followed by this 3 scheduler. So now again, let me add this synchronize method. So same output will be there. So whenever it will be locked with any thread, so only that thread will be allowed to execute and other threads will be in the waiting state. So this is the main application of the synchronization.